at this point in time, I am burnt out. I'm tired. When I come home every shift and I'm thinking, I don't want to go back. So hopefully I will never get to that point where I need to be a sign-off assessor. Touch wood, okay? Because I'll most probably sign everybody off. No, I'm joking. It's not that deep, guys. It's not that deep at all. So from now on, in every single video, I will be answering one question. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start incorporating answers and questions. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. Thank you so much for joining me once again back onto my channel. My name is Belinda, and if you've not already subscribed, please don't forget to press the subscribe button as well as turn on your notification bell so you get a notification every time I upload. So as you read from the title of this video, guys, today I'm doing a how to pass third year, both clinical as well as academically, or academic wise rather. So as you guys may know, that this is literally my last year, last placement. So I literally have 1 week left, guys, on placements, two shifts basically. I've already been signed off for this management placement, so I'm good to say that I have actually passed the course. So if you guys have been subscribed to my channel for quite some time, you guys know already that I did a year one as well as a year two how to pass nursing, both academically as well as on clinical placements rather. If you've not already watched my year one and year two, I'll leave it somewhere up here as well as down in the description box below, so you guys can go and watch that if you are interested. So basically in this video, I just want to talk about my third year experience as a nursing student. How hard was it? The level of expectations they were expecting of us while on management placement, as well as throughout the year, both academically as well as clinically. Because if you are a nursing student in the UK, once you hit third year, you are transitioning from a level 5 academic writing to a level 6 academic writing. So I'm also going to be talking about the assignments that we had, because I know a few of you have been asking me what type of assignments we had within the third year. So I'll also be discussing that, and I'm just going to discuss everything about third year really. So that is what is the topic of discussion in this video. In addition to that, guys, I do want to start introducing something else on my channel. So every time I do a video, I do want to go ahead and answer a question from somebody who asked a question, if that makes any sense. So from now on, in every single video, I will be answering one question, because sometimes there's no point in creating a whole video based on that one question. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start incorporating answers and questions. So if you guys have any questions that you want me to answer for you, please do comment that down below, and I will choose a question and put it in a specific video to answer that, if that makes any sense. So anyway, that's what I'm gonna be doing. So if you are interested, please keep on watching. So before we get into this video, guys, the question that I will be answering is from Adibanke Maggie. So she asked, hopefully I'm not too late, but how do you plan to merge your next stage of nursing after you finish your last 5 weeks with nursing school and merge it with your new course? I find that so inspiring and smart thing to do. So thank you for the question. So first things first, in order to answer that question, I am merging my nursing with the access course to medicine. If some of you may know that I'm going to study the access course to medicine straight after this, but what I'm doing is I'm basically merging the access course to medicine with my nursing. What I mean by this is, by the time I start the access course to medicine, I would have not completed the nursing, if that makes any sense. So what I'm doing is, management placement was a 17-week placement. I wouldn't really say it was 17 as such, because we did get 3 weeks annual leave. I, however, did not take my annual leave. I worked 14 weeks straight. So instead of finishing on the 26th of September, I would be finishing 3 weeks earlier, which is the first week of September. I would not say I would be able to apply for my PIN as yet, because I'll still be in the process until end of September. End of September is when we get our final results, okay? Then we can start applying for our nursing PIN. So how I'm merging the two is by means of taking my 3 weeks annual leave that I was supposedly to have throughout my management placement. Rather than finishing on the 26th of September, I'm finishing the first week of September, so 3 weeks earlier, because the rest of the 3 weeks in September is basically my annual leave, but it's not really annual leave because I will have started the other access course. So basically you could say I'm not having a break in between, but it is what it is. All right, guys, so hopefully that answers that. So going back to discussion point of this video, so first things first, I do want to say that year two, guys, still remains up to this point the hardest year throughout nursing. It hasn't changed. If you ask many students or newly qualified nurses, they would say that literally second year was the hardest, both academically as well as on clinical placements. Even now that I'm completing my final year, I have to say third year was easier than second year, if I could say that. I did mention in my second year video that it was really long and the assignments were overlapping each other. So it's like they would give us one assignment. By the time that assignment was due, they would literally give us another assignment. But I don't know whether it's just the university that I go to, but it was like that, okay? In addition to that, academically, it was firstly us having to learn how to transition from level 4 academic writing to level 5 academic writing. So level 4 to level 5 academic writing, the change that I came across was that when they were marking our assignments, we had to be able to critically analyze information. They were very, very strict on that, okay? And obviously in year three it gets more intense, as well as on placement. Obviously at that point in time they were expecting you to have a broader sense of knowledge rather than year one where you were being spoon-fed, okay? And then this year was full blast. So that's the comparisons that I really want to do from second year to third year. So firstly, I want to talk about academic wise what kind of assignments that we did in the third year. I know some people were asking me, Belinda, what assignments did you have? And obviously, guys, first things first, I do want to say assignments vary. And also, if you do go to the university that I go to, they do change content, okay? It's not necessarily that you would be doing the same as me. However, I'll still give you a glimpse in regards to what assignments we had this year. So first things first, we have a mathematics exam, all right? This mathematics exam, guys, was a land-based calculator, if that's what you want to call it. Due to COVID, we could write the exam at home, obviously. So you had to get 100% for the exam. I did do mathematics videos in regards to past nursing mathematics exam paper, so I'll leave it somewhere up here as well as down in the description box below. If you are interested in knowing that, you guys can go ahead and look at that. So we did do a mathematics exam, once again, that we had to get 100% for. The second one, guys, was a report, okay? So I believe it was a 3,000 word report that we had to write. So we had to choose a topic of our choice. We had to provide a critical and reflective analysis of complex aspects of nursing. So in regards to this, it was more of implementing and proposing a change in regards to nursing. So my topic, if I can remember it, was about diabetes. Once again, guys, every topic I choose is literally about diabetes. If we are given a choice of assignments and topic choices, I would always choose diabetes, around diabetes, if that makes any sense. It's because I've got quite a lot of knowledge since I did year one. I've been choosing diabetes. Anyway, the title rather that I chose was, let me see. The topic I chose was a change management proposal to implement a self-management education intervention to optimize medication adherence among patients with type 2 diabetes. That was basically my topic. So with this assignment, we had to implement a nursing model. So the nursing model that I chose with this assignment was the NHS change model, just because I personally found it easier. However, that's not the only one available. There's quite a lot of common nursing change models that you can use and implement. So if you ever come across assignments that expect you to implement a nursing change models, there is quite a number of nursing change models that you can use, such as you've got the Kurt Lewin model, I believe, which is a force field model and talks about freezing as well as unfreezing. So I'll leave the others up here somewhere on the screen so you guys can have a look at it. So basically that is what we had. So we had to choose a topic that we wanted to choose in regards to what changes we wanted according to our field of practice. And you could choose whichever topic you want to choose, or you could come up with your own, if that makes any sense. So we did that one as well. The third assignment that we had was supposed to be anatomy and pathophysiology exam. However, due to COVID and not being able to write it, they changed it to a 3,000 word assignment. Once again, the 3,000 word assignment was 1,500 part one and then 1,500 part two. Basically, what the assignment was about: working in partnership with service users and carers. So we had a 1,500 word essay that we had to write, and then also a 1,500 word transcript analysis, if that makes any sense. So this was a case study that the university provided for us, and we had to basically answer the question that followed after the transcript. It was not short answers, it was rather long answers, hence I say that it 1,500 words, okay? So that was basically that. To be honest with you, I'm not gonna lie to you, I didn't do as well as I wanted to do in that assignment. I believe I got 68% for that assignment. Reason for that was because I just didn't understand it. It was a transcript analysis, and I was just like, what are they asking us to analyze, you know? So yeah, academic wise obviously, as some of you may know, it's a bit harder because everything was taught online, and if you didn't understand something, you basically had to guess and go with it, you know what I mean? So it was a bit of a hit and miss. In the fourth assignment, guys, was obviously the dissertation. I did make a video in regards to the dissertation. I'll leave it somewhere up here as well as down in the description box below. I did very, very well in the dissertation, I must say. Literally, the dissertation, guys, was my highest grade I've ever received throughout the whole 3 years of nursing, okay? I remember I got 85% for that dissertation. So I was really, 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 really happy with that mark. So in regards to the dissertation, guys, I do have videos coming out, chapter by chapter videos, because at the end of that video, I did ask if some of you guys want to see a chapter to chapter, you know, clear explanation video, and you guys did say yes. So that is what I'm going to be doing, and I'm going to be using my dissertation as a form of, you know, example, if that makes any sense. And then obviously we had all the mandatory training online as well. It's almost similar to e-learning. Those are the mandatory training online. So there was a couple of those that we had to do as well. So I would say year three academic wise was fairly easier than year two. Although at the beginning of year three, we had the two assignments overlapping each other as well as we were on placement. So it was a bit too much at the beginning. I must say, once we submitted our dissertation, everything went so quick. If you ask majority of newly qualified nurses, they will say to you year two drags and drags, but year three, literally, it goes so quickly by. And I must say it did, you know what I mean? Like, when I think about where I started, and that was just like a few months ago, and now literally I have got 1 week left, and you know, I've already been signed off. That is really a weight lifted off your shoulder in a way. So I am 100% sure that I would come out with a first class, definitely a first class, if not a first class 2-1. So I would really be gutted if I come out with a 2-1, because that means I would have missed a few marks in between to get a first class. But either, it doesn't matter. I do want to say this, it doesn't matter what you get, okay? We all want to do well, but don't pressurize yourself to go and get this, because this is the thing. If you are that type of person that you know that you don't want to study further after this degree, that's fine. I know of so many people that they couldn't care less what they get as long as they pass, because they've got no interest in studying further. If you have an interest in studying further, obviously you need to do your adequate research in regards to what grades are they expecting. For instance, if you want to study to become an advanced nurse practitioner, majority of universities are looking for 2-1. However, if you've got no interest in studying again, it doesn't matter how much you get. You understand what I'm saying? Because if you pass with a 2-2 and I pass with a first class, if we are typing our name on the NMC registry, both of our names is going to come up. However, for me, the reason I worked the way I worked is because I knew that I wanted to study further. Hence, I put all my effort in and all my assignments, 100%. So Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. So next, guys, I do want to talk about placement. We had two types of placement. Obviously, some universities get three. Once again, guys, it varies the university that you go to. And this year, our placement were the longest. Now, the reason for that, I believe, is because of COVID. Firstly, because last year our placements were cut short, but this year our placements were more long. For the first placement, it was more of a 14-week placement, but we had 2 weeks annual leave. And then this one was a 17-week placement, but we were given 3 weeks annual leave. So basically, it was more of a 12 and 14-week placement. Okay, so my very first placement that I had was in a cardiology ward. I did do a night shift vlog there, so I'll leave it somewhere up here. And then this management placement that I'm on at the minute is a surgical assessment unit. I was a bit gutted because I was really wanting to go to A&E, but it is what it is. So that was my two placements. I must say, my year three first placement was a bit more relaxed than management placement, obviously. I believe nothing less would have been expected. So management placement, guys, was different because we were given minimal supervision. So some of you may know that we are normally supervised by a registered nurse, which is our supervisor or assessor, either, but we were given minimal supervision. So I was advised that by my management placement, I need to already be working like a qualified registered nurse. Okay, that was one of my outcomes that my assessor wanted me to achieve. So basically, that means working independently, showing my own initiative, having some sort of knowledge about everything, really. At that point in time, I would say you should have about a good 85% knowledge about everything. So basically, management placement, simply put, you'll no longer be spoon-fed. In year three, there was no excuses why you didn't know something. Sometimes you might be in a situation where year one you passed, year two you passed, and then come year three and you come across that mentor or that assessor, as they would call them, that would literally look at you and think, are you ready to be a registered nurse? Are you ready to be qualified? Are you ready to go onto the NMC register? So it's like, so there was a high level of expectation. Your management placement will be hard. I come home every shift and I'm thinking, I don't want to go back because I'm tired, but it has to be done. So it will be hard. Firstly, because your assessor has a very difficult task at hand, and that task is to sign you off. They are your sign-off assessor. They have to basically acknowledge that you are competent to go on the NMC register. And that is a really difficult task. And sometimes you come across assessors that are very special, if you know what I mean, very, very, very special, and they try to make things more difficult than what it really is. So hopefully I will never get to that point where I need to be a sign-off assessor, touch wood, okay, because I'll most probably sign everybody off. No, I'm joking. So once again, in year three, it varies because your assessor rather sets certain standards for you to achieve by the end of your placement, or certain objectives. Let me see if I could possibly find my book. So I fetched my book, so I'm just gonna read out some certain objectives, for example, so you guys can get some sort of idea. Okay, so identification of learning objectives in practice. So my assessor wrote to develop knowledge and skills with the exposure on our surgical assessment unit, which would help Belinda to transition from being a student nurse to a registered nurse in the next few weeks. So that's basically one of the objectives that they set out for me at my initial meeting, and then obviously final meeting. So final meeting, let's see if I can find that for you guys, because it's just nice to know, isn't it? So my final meeting was as follows. All agreed objectives have been met in her mid-placement review. Belinda was able to be consistent in meeting these objectives and has been continuously growing in terms of knowledge and skills in the surgical assessment unit. So according to my assessor, I have met my objectives already within my mid-placement. So he already wrote in my final placement that all objectives have been met in my mid-placement. Hence, they were more than happy to sign me off. But that's just a basic example that I wanted to show you guys in regards to the type of standard of objectives that they would want you to have on a placement setting. So very, very important is independent. You need to be able to work independently, because once you qualify as a registered nurse, you are required to work independently. So my advice is to try and build that independence and initiative and confidence while you're on placement, because by the time you qualify, you already know what needs to be done, if that makes any sense. So for instance, if you are given a placement on a certain ward, say now you are given a placement on a respiratory ward, prior to going to that placement, do a bit of research what the ward is about, so you can have some sort of idea about the basic treatments that they would treat on that ward. For instance, on a respiratory ward would be asthma, COPD, CF, heart failure, you know, etc., etc. Also having some sort of knowledge about the difference between type 1 and type 2 respiratory failure. So basically, in your management placement, or actually don't even wait for management placement, start in your third year. You need to put your best foot forward, if that makes any sense, you know, and just learn from your first placement. So any mistake that you did in your year 3 first placement, try to not repeat those mistakes within your management placement. In addition to that, in year 3, you should already have a good knowledge of medication. Okay, so once again guys, obviously it varies from ward to ward, but you need to have a certain knowledge of medication. But the thing is with me, I feel like with medication you learn it as you go along, you know what I mean? And yeah, so that is basically everything that we did this year academically as well as on clinical placements. That is the standard of expectations they wanted from us this year, especially being on management placement. And yes, I hope this answers all your questions, guys. If you guys got any more questions that you would like to ask me, please don't forget to ask me them down below. And yes, guys, this brings me to the end of my video. I really hope you like it. Please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And I will hopefully see you guys in my next video. Bye. So, tips on surviving your management placement. First things first.